into 2016, and Uganda's chances of attaining more medals from Olympics remain slim. But with all the games most lost, the country's sportsmen and women still thrive to put up better performances. The people who are not talked about much, however, are the brave journalists who cover such events. Uganda Premier League recently awarded our very own Clive Cheze as the best TV journalist, and is here to talk about business ventures in sports Olympics and his coverage of the UPL 2015-2016. Thank you so much, Clive Cheze, for coming to PM Live once again. It's good to have you. We'd missed you on the show.
Thanks for having me also.
What's the most remarkable event you reported during the UPL in 2015?
It's not all about coming on TV after you've read somebody's match report or something like that, but also being on ground. Because we did watch a lot of league football last season, and we did report a lot of league football last season. And because when you go out, you get to talk about so many angles from different aspects. You watch the game, and when you come back on TV, you can give viewers a more detailed kind of report from what you watched, from what the coaches said, from what the players said. And probably those are some. That's one of the reasons that I was singled out as the best TV journalist who covered the league last season. And the show Game On itself in particular was also recognized. But probably if you asked one remarkable thing that I did last season, it was one of those Fridays where you have a show that runs from 2 to 3 and you have a league game starting at 4. Way deep in the village in Buikwe, KCCA was taking on Vipers, the defending champions at the time. And for some reason, because I was running against time, I was determined to take a border from Vision Group up to Uyukwe. That's after Lugazi, and you go inside there. And I remember so many people actually phoned me on the border who were also heading the same direction, but they were in their cars, and they kept on asking if I was fine, if I needed a lift. So, but because I don't trust the Jinja Highway when it comes to traffic jam and all that, I endured the long journey on a border. Now, unfortunately, I didn't make it in time. I missed the first half. The game ended 2-2, and all the 4 goals were scored in the first half, but I was in time for the second half.
You report these sport stories very well, obviously, but what sport do you play as Clive Cheze?
Well, no sport in particular. I only play football to exercise. But before I was done with school, I was an active footballer, an amateur footballer at the time, who thought I would turn pro someday. Professional is when you have a contract, you're earning a salary. It may not be as big as Wayne Rooney or Zlatan Ibrahimovic, but as long as you have a contract and you're paid your monthly wages and your daily allowances, I thought I would get to that stage. But I won't say age caught up with me, but for some reason got busy with work and all that. And the career or the dream just ended like that. But currently, I only play once in a while to keep the body fit and health.
Any chances you might consider starting playing again?
Well, for some reason, we all love football. It is the biggest sport in the world. But my primary sport, actually, it is volleyball. We do a show on TV, and you are required to cover each and every sport out there, just to make sure that you inform the viewers. But I also do write sports for one of the dailies in the country. And my primary sport is actually volleyball. So for me, if you put volleyball and football on the same weighing scale, there's a big chance that volleyball will outweigh our football.
You've already hinted on the issue of professional sport being the fact that someone is giving you a contract and they are paying you a certain amount of money for playing. But can anyone depend on sports to set up a business in Uganda, say investing in the Olympic team?
Sportsmen themselves, they can depend on sports to set up businesses. I've seen it. I have friends, colleagues who are playing football, who are doing other disciplines, and they have managed to earn out of it. Unfortunately, not all disciplines in Uganda can last you the distance. For instance, you love basketball. There are very few basketballers, maybe those who play for teams like City Oilers and all that, can earn a living out of basketball. And probably also those who play for the university sides like UCU, KIU, Ndeje, University Angels. These are institutions that will give you an education. You're giving them a service as a sportsman, they are giving you an education in return. You cannot say about these other teams Rugby, it is purely for fun. Much as we camouflage or sugarcoat it as a professional sport, but in Uganda, it's an amateur sport where people just play because they love the sport and they probably believe they'll get somewhere someday. And it is the same story elsewhere, probably athletics. And only those few selected athletes that go out there, compete in all these international events, get to win something, a medal that has a fee that is attached to it, earn appearance fees and all that. But these other disciplines, for instance, I know for a fact there's no volleyball player in Uganda who has a professional contract. They just play for fun. A few of them who have semi-professional contracts, that's out of the country, maybe in Rwanda.
Let's now move over to the Olympics. For decades, Uganda has only had 7 medals. Just 7. I know 2 of them are gold, but I think 7 is a very, you know, small number. Is it natural that Ugandans will never win, or did somebody cast a spell on us?
I don't think Uganda is cast. You would put it down to not preparing enough for these games and not practicing. But also, in general, as a country, we don't have a sports culture. When you look at the 70s or the 80s, that's when most of these medals came in. The John Akibuwa medal in 1972, the Munich Games. At the same time, the late Del Rabogo, the boxer, did also win silver. 4 years ago in Mexico, that was in 1968, he had won Uganda's first medal, which was a bronze. So he's probably one of the two Ugandans who has won medals at 2 different editions of the Olympics. But when you look at it over time, sports in Uganda has declined because probably there's not much funding coming in. There's not much technical support coming in, and probably the love and passion. Now, most of these athletes are technically gifted. They are talented, but they probably don't have that extra push that you would need to perform at that big stage. Stephen Kiprotich did win a gold medal 4 years ago in London. It wasn't because he was supported and all that. When you get to hear his story, he actually had to invest in him own self, train in Kenya with these other better athletes in Kenya to achieve that feat.
Every day on the show, we look at the good and bad stories from our lineup. It's what we call the Wacky and Dope. Today, the Wacky goes to the boring MOOBS campus bazaar. It's been blamed on the non-teaching staff strike that limited many from attending. And Clive Chaze is dope. He's always on hand with authentic analysis of issues in the sporting arena. Congratulations upon winning the UPL Best TV Journalist Award.
Streets is watching. You are watching PM Live.
Which award won't Ugandans come up with? They award nearly everything. You're saying on awards, now on Connect.
What's cracking, guys? I'm Lenz, and this is Last Week Today. It's where we realize that hardcore news is actually our best source of entertainment. So money will always be an issue in like everybody's life. And if it's not in yours, then you're obviously in a relationship with your hand. Say hi to Palm Ella. So Makerere's money issues have reached a fever pitch. It's so bad that the non-teaching staff are threatening to go on a hunger strike. So on Mac's behalf, I'd like to welcome all the freshers to the Hunger Games. So as it turns out, the grass is greener on the other side. Nkumba Uni has just received 600 milli for completion of a library.
The government has stepped in with 600 million shillings.
Nkumba guys are bowling. Neshing is for the Makerere people. Nkumba guys be like...
Money on my mind, money, money on my mind.
while Makerere people be like,
I need a dollar, 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 that's what I need. Hey, hey.
But privileged kids always get spoiled, and even the best they get always ends up not being enough.
Something good, but then it's bad timing.
But still, we needed more space.
Streets is watching.
Also, at Chambogo University, the non-teaching staff are at it. But the difference with these guys is, they're not going on a hunger strike. No, not Chambogo, guys. So the non-teaching staff locked and padlocked halls and all the facilities on campus.
The postponement was caused by the ongoing non-teaching staff strike.
You don't have to be a genius to see that they are actually holding Chambogo for ransom, which is illegal. So the vice chancellor had a few things to say.
But it's not their right to lock up the facilities of the university.
Let me translate that for you.
So whoever has keys to the university must return them.
We are too stingy to buy new keys and padlocks.
And then for him or her, she can go back home and rest in peace.
You are so fired. Go home and die.
The streets is watching.
So, we can all be bad news. Mutesa I Royal University, unlike some universities, know how to welcome their freshers, who are kind of really fresh off the boat.
Staged at Lido Beach in Entebbe, the bash was organized by the Guild president.
That's why I see red eyes on me, right?
Of course, it's the water that made your eyes red. Alright guys, that's all we had time for today. My name is Lens, and we'll be back again next week with Last Week Today. Peace out.
PM Live.
Thank you, Lens, for rebounding these stories, and thanks to you for your feedback. We are always online for you on Facebook at Urban Television or Twitter at Urban TV Uganda. Feel free to reach us anytime. You could also call the number on your screen. Otherwise, enjoy your afternoon and keep it urban. It's a lifestyle.